Hi dear children, today in English class, English subject, we will start the revision work. Revision works. In English, one lesson from quarterly examination, and that lesson number 2, the town child. And we will once again repeat and this revision lessons. And today we will consider lesson number 2, the town child. Okay, it is a poem, and you must study the poem. How many lines you should study? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 line. That means the first stanza, and in this poem it has two stanzas. One stanza means one paragraph, like that, two stanzas. The first stanza consists of 12 lines, so you should study the 12 lines by head. It will come in the examination. You can expect one poem in the examination. Okay. Then, I live in the town in a street. It is crowded with the traffic and feet. There were buses and motors and trams. I wish there were meadows and lamps. And the houses all wait in a row. There is smoke everywhere that I go. We already studied this is our first lesson. And in this academic year, the poet describes about a child. Actually, the child, he is living in the town, and he does not interest to live in the town because there is a noise. Noise means avaaz or traffic jam, very congested area, number of people or crowd. So he wanted to settle, or he wanted to live in a village. A village means gave. Because there is a very calm and quiet areas, there is no disturbance, there is no noise, and he would like to leave. He would like to change his home to village area. It is a dream about a child. In this book also, picture of a boy. So 12 lines you must by head. I means the town child. I live in the town in a street. It is crowded with the traffic and feel. There were buses and motors and trams. I wish there were meadows and lamps. The houses all wait in a row. There is smoke everywhere that I go. The pronunciation is very important. Each and every word, you should spell the words with correct pronunciation. Once again, I will recite the poem. The poem means we can't say read. The poem actually recited. The poem recitation. The poem competition is known as recitation. Recitation means the poem. But the articles or other lessons, we can read it. But in this case of poem, we are saying that recite. The poem recite. Okay. Once again. I live in the town in a street. It is crowded with the traffic and feet. There were buses and motors and trams. I wish there were meadows and lamps. The houses all wait in a row. There is smoke everywhere that I go. Okay. And in this lesson, one summary also. You should study the summary. Then the word meaning, street, castle, crowded, meadow, plenty of. And out of the plenty of is a very important word. The plenty of means bhusare, a large number of, large quantity of. That is the meaning of plenty of. Here look at plenty of. P-L-E-N-T. For plenty case of, you should add of also. For plenty, dono, a keyword, pronunciation together. Plenty of. For plenty, I say a keyword. It is a two word, but the pronunciation simultaneously together. Plenty of means large number of, large quantity of, large quantity of anything. Okay. And this word is very important to you. And in your higher class also, this word will repeat. Our day-to-day English language also, we are widely using this. There is a common use for this plenty of. I study the word. Then, the next very important is that the fillings blanks also. And fillings blanks means very simple. I live in the town in a dash. Fillings blanks. Answer key also. But if you study the poem by heart, you can easily fill the blanks also. The fillings and blanks, actually it's a poem. It's a part of the first stanza of the poem. But if you study the poem, you can easily do this fillings and blanks. Okay. The next is answer these questions. Answer these questions, total 5 questions. First question is, where does the town child live? You know the answer. Answer, the town child lives in a town. Actually, the answer is also in the question. The town child, he is leaving the town, no doubt. And where does the town child live? The town child lives in a town. The child, the town child is living in the town. Otherwise, he is leaving the town, or his house is in the home, his residence is city. Any answer in your own interest, any sentence you can write, no problem. The correct writing, according to the base of the question, the correct answer, the town, where does the town child live? Here look, where, V-H-E-R-E, where does the town child live? This is the question. Here look, first check the what grammar is used in this. Here is a does. Does means a present tense. It is not a past tense. So present tense answer, the town child. Child ke baad verb plus s or es, that is compulsory. But in answer question may only leave, but answer may leaves. Here is a where. But if you change the questions like that, where did, for example, where did past tense. Or past tense mein aap kya karna, past tense aayega, aap verb bhi change karna, the town child lived aayega. Okay, pehle aap question dekhna, question ka grammar dekhna, and your answer should be based upon the grammar of that question. That is important. That is a basic in the question answer. If you want to study the question answers, and this theory is very important. First, check the grammar of the which tense, present tense, past tense, or future tense. Then your answer must be based upon that questions. Here, where did I go? Answer me. Did means a past tense. And here, look, do does a present tense. Do does a present tense. Or singular noun ke saath does, plural noun ke saath do. Do or does, answer also should be in present tense. But in this case of did they leave. Here is a where does, D-O-E-S, answer is L-E-V-E-S. This is a basic technique for write the question answer without the mistakes. Okay. The second question is also present tense. Why does he not like his street? Why does he not like his street? Answer, he negative sentence, and he does not like his street. Why? Because it was very noisy sound. Oh, jada sound is there, awa jada is there. Then where does he wish to have in the town? All these questions already in your copy. Only one sentence, you can easily study all answers. And why does he love it? And what is one thing that he loves? On all things, the only 5 question answer, you can easily study it. Very, very simple work in this lesson. First work is study the tolu line, first stanza poem. Then second, word meaning. Then fourth is a summary of the poem. Then 5 question answer, then 1 feelings and blanks. Okay. And do all this work today. You should study all this work in your home, and better preparation for the examination. And this type of work, continuous and steady work, that gives a good number in the examination. Okay, bye. Then tomorrow we will study the next lesson. Bye.